All right, great. Well, so as it says, my name is Bill Van Leeuw, and I'm a musician, photographer, and teacher. Tonight I want to talk about a year-long project that I'm engaged in called 52 Things, and encourage you to engage in some projects of your own. So this idea of 52 Things is doing one creative project per week. At the end of 2009, I realized I had this list of projects that I wanted to do, and this seemed like a perfect format. So I do one creative project every week for a year, and then document them on my website. And so I want to kind of talk a little bit about the projects I've done. And I start out, I work on the project. While it's going on, I document it. And then at the end of the week, I post it on my website. And some of the projects that I've done have been sets of photos, videos. I've done pieces of music. I've done do-it-yourself photography gear, physical things, stuff like that. While I'm doing each project, I'm documenting it all along the way. Usually with photos, but sometimes also with video as well. And I think that's a really important part, because I really like the process part of creative things as well as the output. So here's some examples. This is a project that I did in 1 week. This was a sampler CD that I put together for the label that I run. And in 1 week's time, I was able to put together these handmade paper sleeves, photographs, assemble the music, and get it done. And that really turned out well. Unfortunately, there have been a couple projects that haven't turned out nearly as well. This was the effort of 1 week's work. It was a custom cable for some of my flash photography stuff. So this, I ended up not even needing it, and it seemed kind of lackluster after a week's time. But most of the projects have really turned out very well. This is a photograph that I did for a modern and hip-hop dance company called Vertical Ambition. It's a project I've been wanting to get to for months, and this kind of gave me the push to get out there and do it. And what's nice is that one sort of successful project kind of gives you some momentum towards being able to do other ones. So based on the strength of those photos, I was able to go do some additional photography work, have some pieces to put in my portfolio, and have something sort of a unique experience that I certainly wouldn't have otherwise. So hopefully some of those examples have been inspirational to you, and I hope that's the case. But you might kind of be asking the question, what does this sort of mean for me? Well, pieces of music, I suggest that you can do something like this yourself. I don't mean that you necessarily have to do the same format as me, where you're doing 52 things, a project a week. You could do a 365 project where you do one photograph a day. You could do a project a month. But I really think that you can do this, and hopefully I have some tips that could help you along the way. First off, for me at least, this is not about the projects that you have to do, like cleaning the gutters, which I have to do, unfortunately, in the next couple weeks. This is for the crazy projects, the ones that you're passionate about. And that's really important because it really sparks the whole thing. For me personally, just on a practical note, I use software called Evernote to keep my ideas organized. It syncs across a bunch of different things. And so I quickly decided I needed a list of potential projects and then even sort of organize them by week so that I have some look. Another thing, for me personally, whether it's real or perceived, the fact that I'm posting this stuff to my website every week means that I feel like there's an audience that's kind of expecting that, and that really helps me kind of keep motivated and stay on top and make sure that I'm actually doing it. And I think that's important because you have to have something once the sort of initial thrill of the first project or two wears off. You got to have something, and for me that really does it, the need to be posting things weekly. A couple other sort of tips. I think it's really important, like I said earlier, to document your stuff, and it's really easy to take sort of setup shots of something you're doing, or in the process, put the thing down, take a picture, pick the thing back up, and keep working on it. I like that process part of it. Also, I really like using my projects as a way to learn new things. So this is from a do-it-yourself pan tilt bracket that I made for a camera. I hadn't done a lot of work with the Arduino microcontroller, and so I used that project as a chance to get in and dive in and learn that stuff a lot more. And then there are some really sort of more mundane things. Don't watch a lot of TV. For me, that works pretty well. It's tough, but any distraction that takes you away from the projects you want to do really kind of drains your creative energy. I do make an exception for the Celtics games, the finals, but that's just me. And so finally, I want to end by sort of picking up where it's starting. My dad is here in the audience today with my two boys, and so I thought it was only fitting to sort of reflect on the start of where this creative stuff came from me, the first project in two words. The guitarist I ever heard play, the first photographer whose work I ever studied, and as a science teacher, certainly inspired me in my career in education. This is a photo of one of his guitars that I did as a weekly project. So thank you, Dad, I appreciate you being here. So that's basically it for me. You can check out the ongoing set of projects. This presentation is week 31's project. and 52 things. You can check out the full list of the other things that I've done so far this year at my website and then my personal site as well. Thank you so much.